welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you kind of our homeschool plan. So what kind of things I'm going to be doing this summer to keep educating my kids and make sure that they're not forgetting the skills and things that we just worked so hard on learning this past school year. So I'm just going to share with you some of the curriculums and things that I'm going to be using for my rising first grader and first graders, twins, and then my rising second grader. So first and foremost, we are going to be doing a lot of reading. That's no different in the summertime for us than it is in the school year. There are kind of required times throughout the day where my daughter does have to spend time reading to, you know, just to herself. And then if she kind of feels like if she seems like she's getting bored of it, oftentimes I'll have her read to my twin boys who are five. And so they really enjoy that as well. So reading is a huge part of our homeschool, and I read to the kids. My daughter reads, you know, to herself or to her brothers or sometimes to me, and it's a huge part of our homeschool. And so that's going to continue through the summer. So my last video, you guys saw a big Good and the Beautiful book haul. So I love their readers. So that's going to continue. We have tons of readers for my daughter to choose from. I think that's really important. You don't have to buy them all, certainly. Can use your library and resources like that, but I think that it's really good idea to have a lot available to them, so you know, to be able to choose and just kind of get them excited about reading. So we're going to continue that through the summer. There's going to be tons of reading every single day. The next thing we're going to be doing together is the Nature Connection outdoor workbook. I've mentioned this before on my channel, and we've worked in it a little bit, but we haven't been super consistent with it. And so one of my goals this summer is to work through the summertime portion in this book, just a way to kind of encourage us to get outside and explore nature and, you know, take notes, and just showing the kids, you know, that there's so much interesting out there. And I love when we just kind of like discover something and then we can kind of dig into it more with books or, you know, looking it up online and that kind of thing. So anyway, this kind of goes month by month, and it suggests things that you can look at and take note of, and I really love it. This is a great one. So I'll make sure to link everything in the description box below. So if you have any questions about it or you are interested in it, I'll have a link right below this video. It usually says see more, and if you click the little arrow, it'll kind of like pop open a new box, and I'll have everything linked so you can just click it and go right over to it if you want. So I'll just go into what we're doing for my rising second grader. So I got this Highlights Summer Big Fun Workbook. She actually spotted it. They get the Highlights magazine. Their great grandmother gets it for them, and so they get that every month. And she spotted it on the back. My daughter spotted it on the back of the Highlights magazine. She was like, "Oh, look at this!" And so I looked into it, and I was kind of like, "Oh, is that really going to be quality? Anything good?" And I looked into it, and it's actually really great. It goes right along with the things that she's learning. There's addition, subtraction, measuring, reading, writing, all in this book. And I was just really impressed with how spot on it was with the things that she, you know, was already doing in her curriculum this past year. So I feel like this is going to be fantastic for keeping, you know, things fresh in her mind, you know, her not forgetting how to measure and get the perimeter and, you know, all of those things. I feel like this is going to be perfect for her. So this was a great find. I'm really excited. And I also feel like it's something she can kind of do on her own because they're not introducing new concepts. That was something important for me. I didn't want to have her doing new concepts during the summer, at least for the first portion. I'm not sure when we're going to begin back our actual, you know, like core curriculum studies. I don't think we'll take the whole summer off. That's not my plan. But I didn't want her having to learn new things, and you know, at least for the first half of the summer. So she'll be able to pull this out when it's time and complete these little worksheets and things inside on her own, which is great. And of course, if she has questions or whatever, like I'm always right there and she can ask them. But I think that's going to be really good for her this summer. And the next thing is Explode the Code. So I've also talked about these on my channel before. They are great little phonics mastery books that you can get on Amazon. They're very reasonably priced. There is level 1 through 8 I see on the back here, and it is essential lessons for phonics mastery. This is another thing my daughter can just pick up and do completely on her own, and then I'll periodically go through and just check it and make sure that she is doing things right and getting it correct, which has never been an issue. It's very straightforward and easy. So yet again, another thing she can just pick up herself and complete, and just keeping those things fresh in her mind. For my boys who just completed kindergarten, we are going to be doing the Level K primer from The Good and the Beautiful. So I really want them to be geared up to go into The Good and the Beautiful Language Arts Level K in the fall. And they're pretty long ways away from that. They're reading little words. There's just some things that they need work on. And so they're very young for going into the first grade or even completing kindergarten yet. Last year, they're on the very young end. And so I'm having to kind of do things a little bit differently for them. And so we did do the phonics and things last year. And we had to switch around. You'll see that in my other video where I kind of talk about my end of the year thoughts on the curriculum and things. You can check that out. There is a first grade one as well as a kindergarten one. So I'll link that up in the cards here as well as in the description box below if you're interested in hearing more about that and kind of what we used and what we switched to, that kind of thing. But we're doing the Level K primer for my twin boys. The course book, it goes over mastering letters, mastering numbers. They're learning long and short vowels. They're learning how to read simple words, rhyming, sorting, and more. So I think this is gonna be just what they need to prime them for the Level K that they'll be going into hopefully in the fall if everything goes well. And then also comes with this little My First Reading book that pairs right along with it. For my boys, we're gonna be giving them a little bit of a math break for the beginning of the summer, so I'm not gonna be doing anything real strenuous with them. I might do some little worksheets here and there, nothing that I've picked out just yet. If you have any recommendations, I would love to hear that. They finished the Master Books Math Level K last year, or Math Lessons for a Living Education Level K. Yeah, right, Level K. Sometimes I get confused by all the levels. So they finished that last year. So if you have any suggestions for like a little workbook or certain worksheets or things that you like to not learning new skills, but just kind of keep the skills sharp that they already learned, I would love to hear from you in the comments. You can leave me a comment down below. I love to hear your suggestions. But we are gonna be moving on to the Math Lessons for a Living Education Level 1 for my boys. And so that will be at least like maybe the last half of summer before we get into that. So I don't have that book yet because I'm not real sure what direction we're going, but I think that's where we'll be, what we'll be doing. So anyway, that is our plan for the summertime. All those things along with just like tons of outside time and spending time with friends, hopefully if this quarantine and everything lets up, which I think it will for sure, but we're just really excited to spend a lot of time with friends and going on walks and exploring and, you know, tons of time outside in the pool and just enjoying our time. But we also have plenty of time inside where the kids need things to do, and they may as well be doing things that are, like I said, keeping their skills sharp and making sure that they're not forgetting things that we learned this past year. So thank you so much for watching this video today. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.